morning, YouTube. It's morning on the East Coast. How are you?
Just want to touch base with you on wood and stone. Basically, whatever we choose to serve will be our master and enslave us, the Bible says. So with that being said, I want to share with you about serving wood and stone. It was spoken in the book of Deuteronomy in the 4th chapter and in the 28th chapter. So I'm going to start with Deuteronomy 4:28, and it basically, let's read 27 as well. Deuteronomy 4:27. And the Lord shall scatter you among the nations, and ye shall be left few in number among the heathen, whither the Lord shall lead you. Verse 28 says, and there ye shall serve gods with a little g, the works of men's hands, wood and stone, which neither see, nor hear, nor eat, nor smell. Okay. So basically what this is saying is, once, whether it's by disobedience or choosing the curse, because that's biblical as well, disobedience and the curse led us astray, led us to serve other gods, alien religions, the Bible talks about in some places, and men whom our forefathers nor we have known, especially wood and stone. And that's what this video is going to talk to you about today. Serving wood and stone. What that means and how we can get from up underneath it. Because the main thing with God, with Yahweh is that we serve only Him and no other God. And we've been gone astray so long serving wood and stone, men and other things, that we no longer take into consideration exactly what God, what Yahweh wants for our lives. So let's go over to Deuteronomy 28 and 36. Now this says, the Lord shall bring thee and thy king. See, the children of Israel, we always want to appoint a king over us instead of accept who God has for us, even though He knows what's best for us. And we appoint kings like Donald Trump and other people who don't have God's best interests at hand, nor do they have you and I, our best interests at hand. So in Deuteronomy 28:36, it says, the Lord shall bring thee and thy king, which thou shalt set over thee, which you shall set over you, you set Donald Trump over you, America, unto a nation which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, and there shalt thou serve other gods, wood and stone. So we have to figure out, what is this wood and stone that Yahweh keeps talking about and keep telling the children of Israel, because this is still in the first five books of the Bible. So it's talking to those children of Israel, us, our ancestors, who have been very pretty much disobedient their whole walk with God. And He has to keep reprimanding and correcting and giving these kind of speeches out. Hearken unto my voice this day. You will be blessed or you will be cursed. And He also says that He will take His name and His commandments, His ordinance, His laws, His statutes, His Christ, and give it to somebody else to serve Him, who has a willing, obedient, and pure heart to follow after Him and be loyal unto Him. So, let's visit Deuteronomy 28 and 64. And then it goes on to say, and the Lord shall scatter thee among all people, which there's races out here that's scattered from one end of the earth to the other, mixed in with all different kind of races and nationalities. And you are the children of Israel, still going astray, still serving other gods, still serving wood and stone. So, and it says, from one end of the earth even unto the other, and there shalt thou serve other gods. What are these other gods? Which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, Even wood and stone. We back to that wood and stone again. Okay, so it's something with wood and it's something with stone that has oppressed us and kept us down for thousands, at least since Christ left here and probably before then. Because I'm quite sure in Joshua, after the book of Deuteronomy, and going on forth throughout the Bible, the children of Israel have served other gods and have served wood and stone. But this particular passage is, if you go on and read Deuteronomy 28 and 68, this is what it's saying here in this part of the curse. Just so I can just tie this in. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. Into Egypt again with ships. Okay. Who came to a place known like Egypt with all of its paganism and all of its ungodliness? Who came to a place like that on ships? No other nation has went anywhere in this world on ships, at least by choice, without choice, but us. You understand what I'm saying? But the children of Israel. This is saying right here that we will be brought to a place like Egypt again. So we're not going to Egypt or didn't go to Egypt, but a place like Egypt. Is America like Egypt? Does it enslave people? Does it hold you hostage? Does it keep you in bound? Absolutely it does. And it goes on to say, by the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. Okay, so that's the last verse in Deuteronomy 28, chapter 28, verse 68, and that's the last verse of the curse. You will be brought to Egypt again, but this time by ships, meaning people will sell you into slavery. That's it right there, folks. That's the key verse to let you know you have been sold into slavery, okay? So with that being said, the video speaks for itself. Please watch the video. Please understand that you were brought here to worship wood and stone. To me, the wood is the cross. To me, the stone is building other people's empires, the presidential palace. Just building up America. This is what the slaves did. This is what my ancestors and my family has done. And your family as well, if your journey starts with the Bible and ends with the Bible. So with that being said, I want you to enjoy this video. I want you to see what wood and stone is. I want you to get a picture on Jesus is no more on the cross. He's no more in the grave. The stone, that stone has been rolled away. He's no longer on the Roman Empire's crucifixion or cross. I call it a ministration of death because not only did they kill Christ on the cross, they also used the cross to crucify their criminals. And they thought Christ was a criminal. Hence, they put him on the cross. He's no longer on wood. So you have to take him off wood, and he's no longer, the stone is no longer over his grave. So you have to move the stone of death away from your life as well. And this is what really, it's hardness, it's oppression, it's burdensome, it weakens a man to worship wood and stone. You know, if Christ is at the right hand of God, then he's no longer on the cross. And we have to begin to take him off the cross. And not only in this video, you'll see, for this to be in the Bible and for me to be able to go online and find all the wood and stone pictures and visualization that's out there, it's some truth to it. Because there's nothing new under the sun when it comes to the Bible. If the Bible says you're going to worship wood and stone and serve other gods, other men, then so be it, okay? Because that's our men, if you don't know. It's so be it, okay? So we're going to go ahead and get right into this video. And again, you can check out Deuteronomy 4:28. You can check out Deuteronomy 28 and 36. And you can check out Deuteronomy 28 and 64. And it'll tell you about serving other gods such as wood and stone. So get your snack. Get yourself ready. The video's not that long. But it will inspire you and give you some truth. With that being said, y'all bless. Have a great day, and I love you all. Oh.